Developing good range of motion is very important in almost all gymnastic and movement sports, as it makes a wide range of skills both more easy to achieve and more aesthetically pleasing. Proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation, for obvious reasons now referred to simply as PNF, is a stretching technique which is arguably the most effective way of achieving this. Deep stretching designed to improve flexibility, such as PNF, should always be done towards the end of a training session or after a fairly thorough warm-up in order for it to be fully effective and as safe as possible. I will firstly explain the science behind this technique, then I will take you through an example PNF stretching protocol which you may choose to use as part of your flexibility training. Within the tendons which attach your muscles to your bones are receptors called Golgi tendon organs. The Golgi tendon organ's function is to constantly measure the amount of tension in the tendon, which increases as the muscle activates and shortens. In sustained, forceful static contractions, tension in the muscles may build to levels which the Golgi tendon organ considers dangerous. At this point, the muscle is stimulated to relax involuntarily by the Golgi tendon organ as a protective mechanism to help relieve tension back to normal and reduce the risk of damage. This is called the Golgi tendon reflex. If you push hard enough against the direction of a stretch whilst you are nearing the edge of your maximum range of motion, you can initiate a Golgi tendon reflex, causing the muscle to loosen and allowing you to push a little bit further than you would be able to do with a simple static stretch. PNF is probably more easily done with a partner or object to hold your limbs in the correct position and to provide you with something to push against, but it can easily be done alone too. I will now demonstrate an example PNF stretching session to improve box splits, but the same timings in theory can be applied to any stretch that you choose. At first, push yourself to about 90% of your maximum range. The aim is for it to be uncomfortable, but bearable enough so that you can stay in the position for an extended length of time. After a short while, the position should start to feel a little more comfortable as you start to warm into the stretch, and you will feel that you are able to gradually ease further down. After a couple of minutes, you will likely be quite near to your full range of motion, and at this point, you want to initiate a Golgi tendon reflex so that you can start pushing further than normal. To do this, take a deep breath in and then push hard against the direction of the stretch for approximately 10 to 15 seconds without actually changing the position you're in. You should be contracting the muscles which you are stretching hard but completely statically in order to increase tension in the muscles without exiting the stretch. By holding your breath, you can increase pressure in the system even more. After 10 seconds, you will simultaneously breathe out and relax the muscles, and you should naturally slide down a little further because the reflex has loosened your muscles beyond what they would achieve through a simple static stretch. You will now hold where you are for a minute or two until you start to become accustomed with the new position, before contracting for 10 seconds and relaxing once more, and repeating the cycle as many times as you wish. I would recommend that you sit in the stretch for 3 to 5 cycles, which should take you about 5 to 10 minutes. PNF stretching should not be done on a daily basis due to the high demand it places on your muscles and connective tissue. However, if you do it 2 to 4 times a week, you should start to see noticeable improvements in your flexibility within a month or so. Continue these stretching sessions at this rate until you have achieved the range of motion which you desire. Much like gains in fitness or strength, gains in flexibility will start to reverse within a few weeks if your full range is not used, unfortunately. So try to do PNF stretching at least once or twice a fortnight, even once you have reached your desired level of flexibility, in order for you to maintain that level. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it useful. If you did, be sure to like it, favourite it, and share it with anyone else who you think might find it helpful. For more regular updates, be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel. And for even more videos and updates, make sure that you like my Facebook page and subscribe to my training YouTube channel. If you have any comments, suggestions or questions, please leave them below and I'll make sure that I get back to you. Thank you, hopefully see you again soon.